Hello, Dominic from BMT, and in this video I will quickly show you the 5 basic points you need in your stroke. So, the first thing, the first reaction is always get your hands to contact. So if I would not play, that ball would go into my racket. So, I hands to contact, second point, waiting for the bounce, third point, return with the ball, fourth point, we touch the ball, and fifth point, we finish, in this case, our neck. So, hands to contact, waiting for the bounce, then you turn, even the deep balls, no problem, bounce and turn, and then turn and touch, and then you have touch and finish. So, the more you turn out of your hands, the more you will notice how slow tennis is. So, if I turn out of the hands, it's like I have plenty of time. I will do the same ball, and if I do it with my arm, I have to go like way faster to get there. So just by turning the hands, it's almost as I'm playing in slow motion. A lot of people, they turn the arm, yeah. If it's slow like this, it's possible, but if the ball comes faster, people have to start to rush. If it's faster, I just turn my hand and it's still like I'm playing in slow motion. So the faster the ball goes, the faster we will turn out of our hand, which is easier than to turn from our arm. Yeah, I turn a little faster, but that does not change the stroke. Every time the racket goes, short ball, shorter stroke. So the first thing, as you can see on the shorter ball, the racket goes back. The frame goes in the back, in the way the racket is placed with the speed of the ball. The hands also will turn the racket in the position we need for the ball we need. So if I want to play a flat stroke, I will turn the racket more like this. If I want to play more a spin stroke, I will turn the ball and my racket more like this. So, depending on how I want to play a topspin, I turn my racket lower below the ball so I can go a little more up to contact. I want to play flat, I come more from behind the ball. So, let's play a few low. That's a very nice high spin ball. It's a very nice high spin ball. These are more flat strokes. Yeah. I come more, turn the racket behind the ball, and I come in like this. So, turn the racket, spin, that's a spin ball. Turn the racket behind the ball, that's a flat ball. So turn the racket with your hand in the position for the ball you want to play. The finish, it's all about the finish. We can finish between the elbow and between the shoulder. The finish will decide how fast we play and how deep we play. So first thing, we always try to finish to the shoulder. The moment we touch the ball, we turn the back of our hand into our neck. So this part goes up here. This is the basic to start. So hands, bounce, turn, touch, and finish are the 5 basic. You see I turn, and the moment I touch, I'm going to do it slow. The moment I touch, I start to turn that racket to my neck. So the racket will go up on your right side, turning to that finish. Even if you want to play cross, that racket will turn on your right side to the finishing point, which in this case is my neck. So if I touch the ball right and finish in my neck, we play a deep ball. So those are 2 deeps.
Yeah.
So finish to the neck, deep ball, touch, and finish, deep ball, touch, and finish. Now I start to finish to my elbow, and we have the short ball. So the finish will decide where my ball goes. So touch, bounce, and turn, touch stays the same no matter which ball you want to play. You find it, if you want to play a shorter ball, you go to the elbow. So the moment you touch, you finish on the elbow, and you can see you have every time the short bounce. Bounce and turn, I went to my neck, I hit the line, I touch, go to my neck, almost hit the line, I touch, and I have a deep ball, I touch, go to my elbow, and I have the short ball. The two mistakes, too fast and too early. So, I already explained a little bit in the finish. If you start to close too early the racket, you will lose the depth into your ball, or you will even hit the ball into the net. So by going closing too early, or you can say by finishing, by turning the racket too early, every mistake you make, you will make before you touch the ball. Even if you go too fast like this one, it goes out. You want to touch the ball first, and then you want to accelerate. You pull the racket from contact, you can go as fast as you want. All these balls are in. But if I start to go in this part too fast, I will lose every control. So that means you start from back to forth, and by going too fast, the racket does not go away at the time as it should go away. So the most important part for the mistakes is learn to touch the ball first and then you finish. You go slow, you try to move. Chapter number 7, rhythm, try to move with the speed of the ball, then you are never too fast. Yep. Everything starts the moment we touch the ball. Every mistake we make before touching the ball. So if you go too fast, you cannot go away, you cannot make the spin, you cannot keep the control. And if you're closing too early, you change the position, and or you lose depth, or you hit into the net. So be aware of those two. Try to move with the speed of the ball. Touch the ball first, and then decide what you want with the ball.